Last week, the UK government alerted its citizens in Uganda of an impending terror attack against Uganda, further warning them to be extra vigilant while in the country. The Uganda police spokesperson Fred Enanga acknowledged the terror alerts, further assuring Ugandans that the country is very safe.
As the joint security agencies, we remain committed to the fight against terrorism. Those citizens in Uganda to be vigilant at all times, especially in crowded areas and public places.
Enanga, however, noted that these alerts cannot be dismissed because in most cases when terror alerts are issued, they are followed by actual terror attacks.
That many Ugandans were expressing fear and others beginning to panic because from the previous experiences we've had, some of these terror alerts have been followed with the actual incidents of terror attack.
The Allied Democratic Forces, ADF rebel group, remains the biggest threat to Uganda's security following recent attacks they have masterminded in Uganda. Therefore, Ugandans have been urged to be very vigilant and report any suspicious persons, items and activities.
It's important that as a Ugandan, if you see or hear something unusual or suspicious, please report to the police. Any small piece of information could be important.
The FDC party leadership has also advised the government and all security agencies to take the UK's terrorist warning seriously. They have demanded that the government bring back all Ugandan soldiers keeping peace in neighboring countries in order to strengthen the security back home.
Withdraw all Ugandan forces wherever they are to come and defend the borders of this country. Our army, its major role shall be to protect the people of Uganda, their lives and property, and the borders of this country.
Relatedly, following the recent terror attack on Lubiriha Secondary School in Kasese that left over 40 students dead, police say 4 bodies of students remain unclaimed. According to police, these bodies' DNA samples have not been matched to anyone. Parents whose children are still missing have been encouraged to go to Wera Hospital for DNA matching.
And we continue to call upon more relatives to come forward to give us more biological samples so that we can successfully match the samples to the human remains.
Meanwhile, as DNA tests become a popular method of choice for resolving disputed parentage, police have warned of an increase in fake results. Enanga noted that some DNA testing facilities, including hospitals, clinics and medical centers, are unlicensed to carry out these services.
DNA testing reliability is at about 99.5%. So because of that, it has really come out to be one of the best ways of proving paternity relationships and other relationships.
Enanga also condemned the act of publicizing victims of DNA tests, especially the children, whose rights are usually violated. Recently, the Ministry of Internal Affairs reported an increase in the number of people seeking paternity test services by over 70%. The majority of those seeking the services are men who want to confirm whether they are the real fathers of the children they have.
Taking photographs of children who are heartbroken, crying, and these, it's a violence towards the rights of children.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.